So this happened about a year ago, and at the time, I was 17. I'm a male, so this guy hired me to do basic stuff around the building he managed. However, he always gave me this weird feeling like something wasn't right with him. But he paid me $20 an hour, so I stuck by, despite feeling like I should leave. He would often talk to me about how everyone else he had hired in the past would quit because they were weirded out by him. He would ask me if I was weirded out, but I would say no because he's paying me a lot. After a month of this, it came to a climax. He pulled me away from sweeping and told me to take a seat. He told me that I would have to distract him or else he would do something that he would regret. So for an hour, I just talked to him about anything and everything. Throughout the entire talk, he kept saying that he was a terrible person and has done horrible things. He told me I would hate him if I knew what he had did. Throughout the conversation, I was worried he would do something, so I contemplated running or fighting, but instead I just kept talking. Eventually, he seemed to calm down and said I could go home for the day, but asked if I wanted ice cream first. I refused. I got home and texted him that I was leaving. He apologized, and I haven't heard from him since. I want to start off by stating this is my first ever Reddit post, but I've always loved listening to stories from the subreddit on YouTube, and I wanted to share my own. For some background info, I'm female and was 17 at the time of the story. I used to work at a pizza place in my hometown. The job sucked in many ways, but the worst part about it was that my manager had no problem leaving girls alone to close. Granted, the town I grew up in was small and boring, and most people left their doors unlocked, but I still thought it was risky. On this particular night, I was closing the shop alone at around 10. The last thing I had to do was take out the garbage on the way to my car, and the dumpster as well as my car were located on the side of the building. While I was making my way to the dumpster, I immediately noticed a man making his way towards me from across the shop's parking lot. He was wearing jeans and a black sweatshirt, and had some sports cap on. Right off the bat, my heart dropped, and I got incredibly nervous. I threw the trash away and began speed walking to my car when the guy said something.
"You got a cigarette?"
My paranoia told me the question was sketchy as hell, and I struggled to respond for a moment. I just said no and got into my car, hastily trying to get in. I shit you not, as soon as I closed my door, he booked it to my car and tried to open it. Obviously, I had immediately locked it. I instantly started bawling my eyes out and turned on my car. The man clubbed my window with his fist a few times, without a word, before booking it again into the nearby streets. I called my mom and then the police once I got home, and they opened a small investigation, but could never find the guy. There were no other cases of something like this happening somewhere in this town, and so I think he was probably relocated somewhere else to avoid being caught. I really have no clue what the man wanted to do. Sorry if this was kind of lame or anticlimactic, but it was pretty damn scary to me. So to the man that tried to get into my car, let's not meet again. I'm a 17-year-old female. I work at a convenience store, gas station, located on a trucker route. Given that information, I'm sure you can deduce that the people coming into the store aren't always the most respectable. I've had people get a little too friendly, but it's always been a line between, well, maybe they're just being really nice and I took it the wrong way, and this is kind of creepy. But one customer a couple days ago didn't leave much room for debate. I had a guy, at least 30 to 35, if not older, come in. He got his things and came to the register. He started his interaction with, "Hello, beautiful. How you doing?" Already, I felt uncomfortable just by that tone. But I shook it off and simply said, "I'm doing alright," or something like that. I figured that maybe he just had a weird way of greeting people. He wanted cigarettes, so I asked for his ID, to which he said something that sounded really creepy, and how I just wanted to have his picture, or address or something, and he also winked at me while saying it. To which I laughed uncomfortably, and said, "You should know, I'm 17. He responded, "Yeah, right," as though I was lying or something. I got him his cigarettes and cashed him out without saying anything else. I think he called me beautiful again as he left, which just made me uncomfortable all over again. This all happened last week. I was working a late night shift at a bakery. I was starting to close down and I had locked the door behind me as I was walking to my car. When I was at my car, I saw a paper that was stuck to the side of my car. But I've heard a lot of stories about people getting kidnapped when getting stuff on their car in the middle of the night, so I didn't want to take the risk. When I got home, I took the paper off my car and it said, "Hey," and then my real name, which I'm not going to put on here. I thought it could be one of my coworkers, but I didn't know I was going to be totally wrong. Fast forward to the next day. I called off work because I felt ill and had a massive headache. Around 9 a.m., one of my coworkers called me and asked if I could tell my friend to stop calling the shop, asking for me. I asked her who it was, but she said that the person didn't want to give her his name. After the call ended, I called all my male friends and asked them if they were calling into my work. And they all said no. Nothing more happened until Thursday came around. I was cooking up some food, and I had forgotten to buy onions, so I put on my shoes and walked to the nearest shop, which was about 10 minutes from where I live. I was walking up and down the aisle because I was looking for a specific type of garlic powder. When I found it, I was on my way to get the onions. I was grabbing the onions, and when I was about to turn around, there was this tall man that had to be in his 60s standing right behind me. I apologized for bumping into him, and said that I didn't see him. He told me that it was just fine, and told me that I was pretty. I didn't know what to say back other than thank you, and smile. He then proceeded to put his hands on my back and rub it gently. That's when I had enough, so I told him I had to go and quickly walked away. Paid for my things and headed home. I had kind of forgotten about what happened some hours later. The next few days, nothing really happened, more than I got a letter and some phone calls at night. On Sunday, it took a horrible turn. I was at home watching a movie in the living room, which is right next to the main door. There's a wall blocking the way, which means I can see out, but people can't see in. I was halfway in this movie when I heard a loud bang sound, so I tried to look out. I saw the same man trying to get into my house. He was screaming my name and how he was in love with me, and how he thought I looked like his wifey the first time he saw me at my job. I paused. I had completely forgotten that this man had been a customer at my work. I tried as quickly and as quietly as possible to go upstairs, but he started to throw his whole body against the door, so I sprinted to my room and locked my door. I called 911 and explained the whole thing that was going on, and the police arrived at my house in 15 minutes. They found the man in my house hiding under the table, and he had a camera, rope, a pocket knife, and gloves. They took him away, but other than that, I don't know what happened to him. I can't imagine what would have happened if the police hadn't gotten there in time. To the creepy customer, let's not ever meet again. I work as a merchandiser, and one of my stores happens to be in a very high crime area. Tonight, I entered my car, instinctively locked the doors, and grabbed my phone to put in my next job site address. Not 5 seconds after I got in, a disheveled man aggressively ran up to the passenger side and started forcefully yanking on the handle trying to get in. I turned the engine on and got the hell out of there so fast. As I was driving off, he was screaming something at the top of his lungs. I'm not sure what that was all about, but I definitely dodged a bullet tonight. That was frightening. This is something I've never really told anyone about, but I've been thinking about it a lot lately, so here it is. A few years back, 2015 or 2016, when I was 18 or 19, I used to work at a little cafe inside a car parts factory. It was basically a full-out but compact restaurant kitchen and lunchroom for the workers to eat there. Well, this one day, I get a call from my best friend, coworker. She's all kinds of upset because of this new creepy temp worker that made her feel severely uncomfortable by asking her a bunch of personal questions, like what she drove, where she lived, if she was single, had any kids, when she got off work, etc. She didn't want to walk out to her car alone. Mind you, she was my age too, 18 or 19, and this dude was in his mid to late 30s, if not already in his 40s. And we're in Flint, Michigan, so we weren't about to take our chances. I drove up to the parking lot, found her car, parked next to it, and she has a security guard escort her out. We didn't see the guy then, but she described him to me and the security guard, and that was that for a few days. Someone found him and told him to stay away from her, and he did. But then he met me. I knew exactly who he was as he stepped up to the register to place his lunch order, just from the description I had been given and by the creepy vibes he was giving off. He pulled the same intense Q&A on me that he had done to my friend too. But instead of telling him to fuck off or calling security or anything like that, I just told him a bunch of straight up lies. I told him I drove a blue 2012 Honda Civic, which I knew for a fact was one of the second shift manager's vehicle who always parked near the front of the building. I also told him that my shift ended at 9:30, which was really the time that I usually slipped out for a cigarette break. So when 9:30 hit later that night, I walked out to smoke a cigarette and saw exactly what I was expecting to see. That stupid creep in the parking lot close to the area that the Honda Civic was parked. He was just pacing back and forth between two vehicles that was parked a few spaces down in the same row, playing on his phone the entire time. At one point, he glanced up and saw me staring at him, but I had my big leather winter coat on and a hat, so I don't know if he recognized me at first from the distance or not. I finished my smoke and went back inside and explained the entire situation to the security guards, one of which was the original guard that had escorted my friend out to her car a couple days before. And they were dying laughing at the fact that I pulled one over on this prick and had actually caught him being shady. I'm not sure exactly what they did about it, but I do know they immediately went out to confront him in the parking lot and that the guy was fired the same week. To this day, I still don't know what his intentions were, but it doesn't take a genius to figure out that it couldn't have been anything good. So ultimately, the moral of the story is, always have your friend's back and trust your instincts, because if you don't, you could end up cornered in a parking lot and possibly attacked or abducted by a creepy guy who asked you too many questions. Edit, since I didn't include this originally. After my friend and I were informed that this guy was fired, we were told his full name, and my friend paid to do a background check on him. It came back with a violent criminal history of domestic abuse, assault, and battery with a weapon, jail time served for violating a PPO and parole, and some other things. Over 4 years ago, I worked at a warehouse in a small town that I'm from. I decided to leave after my health started to get worse, physically, and I was diagnosed with panic disorder and severe anxiety after the situation I'm about to tell you about. This changed the way I developed friendships after this job, that's for certain. So, I started this job on April Fool's Day, 2018, and I had no high expectations of the job. All I wanted was to do my job, get paid, and go home, as I have two children at home. The job wasn't hard, and it made pretty good money for all the duties considered, so I really couldn't complain. I worked second shift for about 5 months, then I went to the day shift. While working the second shift, I kept to myself mostly until, one day, I met someone after we struck up a conversation about gaming. We'll name him Jeff. Well, Jeff was a pretty good guy, and we had a lot of things in common. I went home that night, and he popped up in my suggested friends on Facebook, which was odd, but I decided to add him. When I did, we started talking more at work, until he suggested that we should hang out, so we hung out pretty frequently. We were friends for a month at this point, and one day, he decided that he was going to introduce me to his partner. She seemed decent at first. Super nice, didn't seem to be the judgmental type, so I was cool with her. From then on, I would hang out with him when my kids were spending time with their mother. one time. We were talking at a restaurant and he started to vent to me. Dude, she's such a bitch sometimes. The other day, I forgot to take out the trash and she threatened to stab me if I didn't. I've never been in a relationship where someone's threatened me, but she's got good intentions, dude. When he said that to me, I was concerned, but of course, we'd only been friends for a month, so I thought maybe he was being morbidly jokingly, so I chuckled at him. He gave me a pretty serious look and said, "I'm not joking, she really did." That concerned me. Fast forward about 8 months, they're still together and we hung out pretty regularly. One day, we were all talking and he seemed a little off that day, so I asked him what was wrong in front of her. He flashed a smirk and said, "Nothing, dude. I'm just a little tired." He didn't have his eyes on me, though. He had them on her when I asked that. When we went to work the next day, I asked him again, "Do you promise it's just between us?" Of course, I agreed. He said that he was breaking up with her, and she went a little crazy. He said that she grabbed her gun and pointed it at him and said, "If I can't have you, no one will." He said he defused the situation and is trying to look for a way out. Not really knowing what to say, I just said, "You'll figure it out, man. If you need somewhere to go, you can come stay with me until you get her out of your house." Fast forward into the next year, he finally decided to leave her. When he did, she flipped out again. This time, he told her over text. She said that she was going to find him and kill him, and he was actually out of work that day with a vacation day. He sent me a text and said, "Hey, let me know if she comes over to work looking for me." This struck me as odd because I had no idea about the situation that was unfolding. She actually did come over to our job, and she asked me where he was. I said, "I have no idea. I thought he was with you, and you guys went out of town or something." All she did was roll up her window and drive off. I called him and told her that she came by, and he called the police about it. They found her up the road with a loaded gun in her car. 2 months later, he decided to talk to her again. He asked if I had seen her around, and I hadn't. He said, "I'd take some vacation days if I were you." Dumbfounded, I asked him why. "Because she's out of jail, and her cousins are in town trying to find people she has personal vendettas with. You're one of them." At that point, I was terrified. I grabbed my kids and went out of town. Took 2 weeks off of work. Came to find the next day, her and her cousins went to the next town over and shot and killed 3 people in an apartment. The reason why he knew that they were coming after me is because they made a Facebook messenger group that he was included in and set a list of names. Everyone regarded it as spam and decided to disregard the message, but he knew what it was. 3 of the names on the list were the people they shot. The 4th name on the list was mine. After they found evidence, he decided to go public about the group and the screenshots that he had. They were all charged with first degree murder. From then on, I was very careful about who I stuck my neck out for, because even though he knew the context of the list and her intentions, he decided not to inform anyone else. Needless to say, we aren't friends anymore, and I dodged a bullet, literally. This happened a few years back, but it was so wild that I tell everyone about it when I'm talking about weird encounters. I worked at Woodfield Mall in the department store. I usually got out by 9 p.m., but this day had ended up there closer to 10 p.m. As I was balancing out my register, I had this intense feeling of dread, like my stomach dropped, and I just had a terrible feeling about leaving the building. If you don't know, Woodfield Mall is one of the biggest malls in America, and it's very busy all the time. I made my way to the employee break room, where the stairwell that led to the second level parking was. That same feeling of dread came over me again. I decided to call my friend and keep him on the phone until I made it to my car. When he answered, I literally said, "I know I'm being stupid, but I'm just nervous to walk into my car alone." As I opened the door to the parking garage, all I see is a giant parking lot, nearly empty. My car, an extra large SUV, and about 4 spots away from my car are 2 cars, surrounded by a group of 10 very seedy-looking people. I immediately tell my friend what I see, and he was like, just keep talking to me and walk as fast as you can to your car, which had my heart racing because I had to walk right past them to get to my car. I hurriedly walked by and jumped into my car. I let my friend know I was good and panicked for nothing. We disconnected and then I hear a tap, tap, tap on my window. My heart sank as I turned to see who was tapping on my window. Of course, it was one of those creeps. I rolled my window down a fourth of the way. I'm in a huge SUV and he was somewhat short, so he couldn't reach in through the window. He asked me if I had a lighter. He must have seen me light up a cigarette as soon as I got in my car. I told him my lighter's on its last leg and might not light, but I hand it to him. He begins to try to spark it while stopping to ask me all sorts of weird questions. He kept asking me if I wanted to go for a walk around an empty mall parking lot. No thanks. I declined multiple times. At that point, I'm just feeling annoyed until I see him pull his own lighter and light his cigarette. Now my head was spinning. Maybe he just used the lighter excuse to talk to me, or maybe it was something worse. Some things become a little blurry conversation-wise because the fear took over, but I remember seeing his friends gathering in front of my car, which made me extremely nervous. I tell the guy to watch out because I'm going to flick my cigarette out the window, so he backs up, and I flick it towards his friends hoping they might scatter. One guy got mad and started getting loud, so I just apologized and said it was an accident. He walked off with a pissy attitude and his friends followed. Thank God. I tell the guy by the window that I have to go, as my gas light goes on and makes a ping sound. The guy hears it and pops up right next to my window and says, looks like you're gonna run out of gas, Miss Lady. Hope you don't break down on the side of the road. Followed by a small, mischievous smile. And then says, maybe I'll see you around. At that point, I don't care if I run his feet over, and I just floated out of there and could hear them all laughing. I don't know what the fuck that was all about, but it was absolutely terrifying, and I spent the entire time looking over my shoulder at the gas station and on my drive home. Stay aware, friends, and always trust your gut. I was 17 when this happened. I had an early morning shift at a restaurant and used a bus to get there. When I got to the bus stop, someone was already there. This was strange because it was so early in the morning. I started to walk to my workplace just to notice the man started following me. Seeing the man follow me got me scared and I started to run. There was just so much off about this man. The whole time he looked at the ground, but also started to run when he saw me running. I quickly ran to the back doors and saw him coming in the same direction. When I closed the doors, he was just a couple meters away from me, and I saw that he tried to open the door that I had locked right after me. When I was pacing inside the restaurant, my coworker came to me and said someone was trying all the windows to get in. We called the cops, and later they told us that the man was carrying a tiny saw with him. Sometimes I think about what he would have done if he would have been quicker than me. Anyways, the saw man. Let's not meet again.